same as my daddy and his daddy before. You hardly ever saw granddaddy down here. They only come a town about twice a year.
What's going on YouTube? My name's Nikki Two Shoes, and I'm coming at you with a video. It's my very first video. And as the title suggests, I kind of wanted to talk about the Balisong community and my journey through it. And I've been in the Balisong community now heavily for like the last 3, maybe 5 years. And when I say I'm in the community, I don't mean people know me. Nobody knows me, and that's better. It's good that way, I promise you. What I mean is I've been silently in the chat groups on Facebook, buy sell trade groups on Facebook, and I've just been observing and taking my steps in that community how I see. And part of this journey that I wanted to talk to you guys about is starting out as a Balisong group member, or as somebody looking to get into the hobby, the sport, the art, whatever you want to call it, for the very first time. So, myself personally, I owned my very first Balisong probably at the age of 18, maybe 20. I got it from a flea market. I don't even know if flea markets are around anymore. I know we still have one, but I'm kind of outside of the city. I mean, I'm in a little town, but it's still like a big thing where you go get produce and stuff like that, and people are selling junk that they have at their house, or people are ordering knives from overseas, like the Balisong, like this, kind of like this Balisong. And that's where I picked up my very first one when I was younger. It wasn't this one. Actually, 3 to 4 years ago when I got back into it, I got a knife just like this handed to me from a good friend of mine who just came back from in town. He had it in a collection of his, and I knew some openings from when I was younger and some different like little tricks. And it re-sparked the interest, which caused me to go get one like this. It's not this one. That one got broke too. And search for Facebook. Search on the chat room, see people talking about Jersey Devil and different forums and different groups where you can go and talk to other people who are interested in this, because it's a big to do for those people in those groups. So I did all that. I learned and started with this. It broke. I bought another cheap one like this for 20 to 30 bucks, depending on what it was shipped. And that's when I really got its hooks in me, and I really wanted to participate in the Balisong community and actually like learn, practice, you know, have fun, do all those cool things, because it's a great, for me, it's a great way to relieve stress. So I wanted to buy my first knife. And man, everybody was talking about how like you can't own clones, how they rip off the person that's designed the knife because they're not paying for the odds and ends and the stuff that goes into it, you know, with all the legal fees, the patents, the testing, the prototypes, the actual thought for the design. And I agree with them. I do. I agree with them 120%. Cloning does rip off the manufacturer. It definitely, I don't know how bad it hurts the community. I don't know how bad it hurts the guy that's making the knife. Might just make them look bad for all I know. I'm not a business end of it, but I do know that if you rob somebody's idea, you know, it can be justified. You know, you can take legal action against them in the state of, or in the US of A. But these guys are doing it in China, so there's not really much ramifications or anything anybody can do about it. Hell, now that I think about it, when I was a kid, there was a shop by me called New Look. That's all they sold, was like Nikes and Jordans and random stuff copied and made in China that they brought over. At that point, nobody really knew the difference. You know what I mean? Nobody was paying attention. There wasn't social media and all this outpour of people who knew what was going on. It's like the fake jerseys that were going around. I mean, I probably got 10 of them in the basement that I didn't know were fake. Just saying. But that's what you couldn't buy. So I followed this elitist perspective, which it is, and it's the right perspective. I'm not going to debate that with anybody. But I followed that to a T, and at the time, the best knife for me to purchase under $200 that I could find, and actually I got it for under $100, was this Bradley Kimura 11. Now, this was at a time when they weren't in production. I'm not sure when Kimura started or got bought back or fired back up. I don't know if it was a 18-inch blade show or something like that. But I bought this knife. And I learned and I started to flip it. And I lost a screw because I kept Loctiting them. And these screws do not stand for shit. And I bought this knife. And this knife is trash. I'm sorry. I don't know how the new Kimuras are, the new Bradleys are. This knife is garbage. And you can see, this isn't even in good condition. Somebody knows what an 11 is. This thing's beat to shit. Somebody polished the blade, trying to give it a new look. They tried to do something with the handles. It's got barrel spacers. I don't even know if it was supposed to have barrel spacers. But this knife is absolute garbage. So I bought this. I was really proud because I bought my very first authentic knife. I could take a picture of it, send it to the groups. They wouldn't ban me. Nobody would talk smack on me like I was the kid, the poor kid in high school that couldn't afford the new tennis shoes. Life was good. But then when I started to hate it, like I wasn't getting any better, and it was really hard to hold on to. My cheap CCC was flipping better than this. I realized maybe I had made a mistake. And I broke down, and because guys, I mean, you got to be honest. Like, here's my BRS. This knife costs a lot of money. And some of us like me, like who loves the hobby and is going to carry this every day and use it, I'm okay with the amount of money I spent on this knife. A lot of people aren't, especially for their very first knife. They're not good with, spending that kind of money. I'm not going to price drop. If you're watching this video and you've been looking at Balisongs, you know what this knife costs new. Blade HQ will tell you what it costs new. Blade HQ will tell you what this one costs new. And the last I checked, this is a HOM Chimera. The last I checked, they were still in stock, which is pretty good for people who are interested or looking for this kind of knife. You know what the price is on those knives. I don't have to tell you. So that's up to each person to decide, but I can't tell somebody that this is the only thing you should purchase. Let me help you. If this is your hobby, sport, and if you're not making a living making videos like this, like I'm not making a living making videos like this because I'm terrible at it, you might not have a business owning a knife like this. Or maybe you can't justify it, which I can't blame you. That's like the USP Matrix. I love to see that knife. I'd like to touch it and play with it a little bit. We'll keep out those overtones, but you know what I mean. I'd like to get my hands on something like that. But that's, I think it starts at $700 or $800 before you get it the way you want it. Some people aren't going to buy that, and that's fine. So when I got to that point where I needed something that flipped better than this, but I couldn't afford this at the moment or didn't justify this, I bought this. I did. This is a BRS. Well, first off, it's not a BRS. It is a clone. Of a BRS replicant. I think this might have been one of the first runs or second production runs that the cloners ever did of these. Because it still has there's the logo. It still has the BRS logo on it. I don't know if they do that anymore. Still like blatantly put the name on it. But that's what this knife was supposed to copy. A replicant. This is in the community. Or at least when I was first starting, this was the knife to own. And I still to this day have not caught a drop for a replicant. The last drop I saw, and I know they've done the standard, they had the alt blades, and I really don't like those on that knife. But this is a clone. And this thing has actually, I've had this for like 2-3 years. What's that there? That knife I've had for 2 or 3 years. This thing has taken more abuse than a lot of knives I've had. I've cut myself. I've split my hands open. This thing has been around, and I abused the living crap out of it, and I was able to learn tricks. I was able to flip this and get a positive result from it. This was a negative. This is a positive. And learning the tricks I did and having something that was very, very flippable for the price enabled me to later to buy this. And I mean, I'm not just saying it, not just because I bought a clone was I able to buy this. No, the clone satisfied my urges to purchase a real, very nice knife. But was unsure of whether or not, you know, it was worth it for me. And I, you know, my financial situations changed. I saved money. I ended up getting another job that paid more, that I could afford to blow money on this, because this is, money's gone. Not getting it back. I mean, even if I sell it, I'm probably not going to get what I paid for it. But this was the lead up to me being able to buy things like these. And justifying it because I could play with, I knew how to do them. And at this point now, you know, I'm in the same ballpark. You don't buy these, dude. Don't waste your money. Do not support the cloners. Don't do it, man. Support these guys. I took that same mentality to a buddy of mine when I brought my Fly Tie 51 that's not here. I took it to my job and I started flipping it. My buddy was like, wow, you know, this is awesome, dude. How, do that trick again. Show me that. And I was doing it, you know, and it was pretty cool because I'm trash, but he thought I was awesome. And, you know what I mean? I'm just an average guy when it comes to flipping them. But I got my, you know, he got hooked. Man, I have somebody else to flip with. I was so excited. I could show him moves. I didn't have that. I had to learn everything from freaking YouTube. So I show him, you know, my benchmate. I show him the 51. I think it was on sale at the time for $200 brand new, which ain't bad. In the secondary market, you're going to pay two or under two for a beater or for a used one. And he did the same thing I did 5 years ago. Couldn't justify, man. Can't justify spending that kind of money. And I thought it was weird. You know, I didn't even think about it because I was in a better financial situation. I was in a better place than I was when I first started. When I was in the same spot he was in, you know, looking at getting my very first butterfly knife, my very first Balisong, because that's what they are, butterfly knife, Balisong. I couldn't do this, and he was at the same spot. And I had a catastrophic failure for my friend. I took the elitist mentality, and I immediately started jamming, you know, knives that were in that ballpark. We all know the ballpark. 51s to Homs to, there was no crack or racking or cracking or whatever it is. The drop just ended. The Alpha Beast, I got a notification that an Alpha Beast drop was coming. I told him about that. I didn't even think that the amount of money that these knives are would even flinch him, because we're in a better job, but it did. And I don't blame him. It shook him. So instead of me going like this, because we don't buy clones anymore, man. Oh, that ship has sailed, baby. Done with these. I let him buy a freaking Baron Sons. I don't even know the damn model. The Ops, Bear Ops, the all black carbon fiber one that you can get it in the orange carbon fiber with the trainer, the black with the live blade. Hey. And I had heard mixed reviews about it my entire career, or my entire involvement in the Balisong community. And I told him, I said, you know what, I heard mixed reviews on it, I have no idea how long it's going to last. And I didn't even bother to stop and go, whoa, time out. I have this you could play with. Nope. I let him go, man. He ordered that Baron Sons. I said, hell with it. What's the worst that can happen? That's the way people do it, right? Buy an authentic. 3 days after he bought it, the tang pin on his, boop, gone. Broke. Gone. In half. Called Baron Sons or whatever the hell it is. They told him, man, ain't no problem. Call Blade HQ. They'll get you a new one. He called Blade HQ for 4 straight days. To the point where he fixed the knife while he was waiting. And then finally, I told him, email him, man. This is, you know, I mean, it's the new age. Everybody emails. Email. Woo, customer service. It took them 7 to 10 days to get back to him and tell him to contact Bear. At this point, man, he replaced that tang pin with a roll pins. put a roll pin that was thinner down there and a roll pin on each side that kept it. And he smoothed the edges down so it was round. And here we are 3 months later. He still has the knife, but now it's smushing like this guy. You see, it's the cups are worn in and it's squishing. And you know, they're touching. And he's back to not happy, and he's looking at buying another knife. I'm trying to see about selling him my Fly Tie V2. It's a headache. I bought them separately, and I'm personally having an issue getting the push pins in properly to get the washers to fit. I can get one washer on each side, but not two. So I haven't got the push pins, I guess, in far enough. Yeah. So it's starting to get on my nerves, and I have two really good knives, in my opinion, that I love flipping. So that knife may be on the outs. It's the V2 scales for the Fly Tie. So it may be on the way out. I'm thinking about if he likes it, selling it to him. Because I really do feel bad. And what really sucked was after I'd gotten, you know, these knives, and he had already got the Bear, I was actually looking up the chat. Because this is my new favorite. BRS, I love you. Fanboy for life, hashtag BRS. I don't even know what hashtag is. It looks like the pound symbol, but whatever, man. I'm a giant BRS fan after this knife. I love it. Beautiful, beautiful knife. But I was looking up the chat because I love the way it looked. The full channel looked awesome. And I clicked on a video. I saw somebody. I was like, oh, reviewing Chad. It's the one. And I was like, awesome. And I started watching it, and I loved the sound of it. The guy was flipping it, and I noticed it was Zen Pin. And I was like, something's wrong. I didn't know the Alpha Beast came in Zen Pin, because I really like Zen Pin. I do have a lot of Tang Pins, but I really like Zen Pin. It's one of the reasons I bought this knife, that and the hidden latch that I took off for the barrel spacers. Listen, if you buy this knife, if you buy the HOM and it feels sluggish to you, get you some Kuski, K-U-S-K-I, Craft barrel spacers. Dude does phenomenal work, and they are awesome. Done. I'm not going to talk about that knife again. But I found this Chab, I thought it was a Chab, in Zen Pin. And then I come to find out, it's from EuroBalisong.com or something like that. And it's back to guys, the one, the old cloner, I think. He has his own website now where he's selling clones. He's got ABs called, or I'm sorry, he's got replicants called Ref. He's got basilisks from HOM calling them Baliscos or some bullshit. He's even copying the squid trainers. I don't know what the guy's doing. But with me thinking about how my elitist mentality went and feeling bad for my friend, I ordered the Chab. I did. I want to know what quality they are before I go yelling at people and telling my buddy to waste more money. I'd rather waste mine because I feel like I messed up. I really don't think I did him a justice. So I ordered one. I don't have it. I paid for the expedited shipping. I don't even know what it costs. It was like, I bought it a couple weeks ago. It's like some type of holiday over there. So I had to wait till today. I think Monday, whatever today's date is, the 7th. I'm looking at the calendar. I had to wait till Monday for it to ship. Tracking will be up on it. I imagine it'll be the end of this week, next week. I may do a video on it. I don't know why I would. I think if I do another video, I might talk about some of these good knives. Because I want these companies to get my money. But, man, I really did turn into an elitist. You know, back when I couldn't afford anything but this, and this was the best flipper at the price. And you can hear it. It wasn't always like this. Bushings wore out of it, probably. I haven't changed it, or I haven't cleaned it or taken it apart in a while. But this knife, it flips just fine. It flips better than this. Way better than those. Those are those. This, crap. This is good. I think I did it, my friend, a terrible injustice, which is what prompted this video. So here's my final words. I am an advocate for flipping. I am for flipping. Not for buying $400 knives. You buy what you can afford. Tell everybody else. and go buy what you can afford. What gets you to flip will get you into, like, to be part of this community. However, these elitists that all have allegiances are fucking fanboys to the fucking fullest. I'm probably going to get banned for that. Probably have to redo the video. But the guys that are elitists, that are fanboys to the end, are going to tell you you're a piece of crap for this. Don't listen to them. Some of them are pieces of crap. I'll let you find out on your own. I've watched videos where they flat out told me what a piece of crap they were. And I don't want to hear it. I'm here for you. I want you to, if you get this and this causes you to flip daily and get better, buy this. Because if you buy this like me and you love the sport, the hobby, the art, you will buy this. I promise you. And maybe one of these. And maybe one of these. And then you'll fall down the rabbit hole. But you have to commit to it. And if this makes you commit to it, if you can learn from this, if you split your hand open on this, if this $100, because what blows my mind is nobody has found a knife other than a trainer in a price point of 100.5 below. What bothers me is there's a guy over in China that has a full business running, selling clones of this knife, of a similar knife, of the basilisk or whatever. Maybe it's the spect. I think it's the basilisk. He calls it the Balisca. If he can freaking clone these and clone this to the point where he makes it a Zen pin, why the hell can't he change the handles? Like, put an extra gap in here and change the chevron direction. You spent time and money making a channeled version of this. Now, however you did it, whether you milled it or it's molded, whatever the hell you did, you wasted time to do that so you could tap holes here and make Zen pin. Why didn't you waste and take the time to freaking change the handles a little bit? Change it 10%. You would have had a price-pointed knife that's $100 to $150 where people would have loved it. And you wouldn't be knocking people off and the community could have got behind it. Instead, you just continue to freaking copy somebody else's work. Take 10 minutes and do it, dude. You're making a killing on clones. Put some of that money into making your own blade design. Hell, it ain't even got to be a blade design. Slap a bowie on the bitch and make a handle. $100 to $150 out of titanium. People will eat it alive. I'm getting worked up. If this is what you can afford, flippers out there, buy these. Join your community. Sit in the shadows. Flip till you get good. If you post videos, throw them on Instagram, throw them on anywhere. Just don't get banned from your groups because they're asshats. Which they shouldn't be banning you for flipping. They should be encouraging you to flip what you can and what you can afford. Because once you get your hooks in you with this, man, you'll buy this. Or you'll buy this. I like buy this. I'm telling you, if you can afford it and you got the money laying around and you're a rich guy trying to learn, buy one of these. They're amazing. Or this. It's a good knife too. Or this. But if you have to buy this, by all means, buy something. Buy something that's better quality than this. Because this will make you hate the game. This will make you love the sport. Stay in the sport. Squid Industries. These are the people that I will tell you to go buy. If you like a trainer, you're in California, I'm sorry. Oregon. Any of the states that don't allow live blades for you to carry. And you want to take us. This is the Mako. They make a lot of really good options. They're aluminum. They can only take so much of an abuse, but they're fantastic. I think my blade's bent. They're fantastic for the money. Awesome flippers. Get you a Squid Industries trainer. If you got the money, get you a Halm. Jeremy Halm does wonderful things. The tolerances are usually really good on his knives. And I love the blade on it, even though I got it taped so I don't kill myself. I don't know why I taped it. I think I had taped it a month ago while I was learning it, and I never bothered to take it off. His first Zen pin one. I love this knife. I needed the barrel spacers, but it's a great knife. Jeremy Halm making a good product. And by all means, buy a BRS. This is my new favorite. This is my everyday carry. I love the Alpha Beast. I love the Bowie, thanks to the gentleman that sold me this in the secondhand market. If I wouldn't have got it at that price point, I wouldn't have bought a new one. I wouldn't have bought it so soon to the other knives I purchased, but he had it up for a great price. You know who you are if you see me. This is an awesome, authentic knife. I love this. I carry it every day. This is my new baby. So, by all means, buy BRS products. And if you can get a bare bones, get a bare bones. I just know, don't get this. Don't get a bare ops. Those knives are crap compared to this, and that's sad. Buy this if you're going to spend $100.50. If you're not going to buy a trainer, buy this. But if you can afford it, man, buy a bare bones, buy a 51. I mean, 51's a good flipper. You can get them on the secondary market for about the same as, you know, 100 and a half, 200 bucks. If you got to go low, this is the only really way, other than a squiddy. You guys do you. I love everybody. I want everybody to stop hating, stop bullying people. That's not cool, man. Remember, you're only being protected by a computer screen. Just saying, guy. People need to spread more love, more peace in the world, and stop picking on people for not being able to afford what you can. Not everybody's in the same boat. Get a knife in your hand. Get flipping. Mad love. Thanks for listening. Peace.